Hello guys, welcome back. Wolf is welcome you back, as you can see. He loves to play with his ball. Wolf! Wolf! I love his face, I love his eyes, I love him as much as I can. We have air condition on here. Inside here we have around 22 degrees Celsius. Get your ball! And as you can see, Wolf prefers the cold floor than his bed. And the funny thing is that the air condition is exactly above and hitting Wolf. So, enough about Wolf. Let's get back to our project. In the last video, I had completed the hull, and also I did some sanding. As you can see, we have a clean working place again, and now it's time to make the second layer of the hull. For me it's kind of boring because I have done this process once, and now I have to do it twice. And the funny thing is with the second layer is that you don't need to bend them a lot. It's flexible. It's very, very flexible, as you see. I haven't even soaked them in water. But the problem is that you cannot cover easy all the corners or curves like here. You have to do some extra work to do that, and also you have to be very, very careful when you sand it down, because as you can see it's very thin. Definitely it's easier to apply this, but it's more appropriate if you haven't have any experience in doing the hull. For my level, or for any others level that are able to make the hull easily, it's boring. So let me place the camera tripod and get started. So guys, I have Wolf that threw his ball once again under the bench, so probably we'll have to pause again the video to catch it. Yeah, I'm going to have to do that. Give me a moment. So he's got his ball. Let's do some work here. I'm cleaning the surface as much as I can. No need to do that much. The good thing is that these wood strips have exactly the same width as the lower wood strips. So all you have to do is glue them on top. It's not going to be easy, but it's not going to be hard. So let's start from the bow. I haven't sanded it with a finishing type of sandpaper, and you can see that even though I haven't, it's very hard to keep it and glue it because the surface is now very, very smooth. So that is going to be a long waste of time, but okay, what else can we do? Keep all the pieces that you cut because you're going to need them. Definitely you're going to need them. We have a lot of cutting to do and adjusting, and this is going to be a pain in the you know what. But okay. When you place the above or below wood strip, make sure that you have no gaps. In some points you may have gaps, okay, it is normal. Like I said in the previous video, when you place 50-100 wood strips in some place, you're going to have gap, so there you're going to use wood putty, or you're going to have to cut small pieces of this wood strip, of the same type of wood strip, and you're going to apply them to cover the gaps. This is what I hate. The upper part of the lower wood strip has not glued well. This is what I hate with that type of planking. And because these wood strips are so thin, sometimes glue goes through them and onto your fingers. Just amazing. And this is where these wood strips come in handy. See what I mean? Let me glue that and I'll get back to you. So finally the glue did its work. Now I have to cut open carefully these openings. And also here. This is why I hate the two-layer planking. Let's put again some glue. Leave it a sec to dry. Continue with others. This is okay. So I will continue the same way, exactly the same way. I have to reopen, of course, all the gun ports, and I will change the way I'm going to do the plugging, of course, to from this point, not from this point, because this is much, much harder. So let me do some more, and I'll get back to you. And so, guys, as you can see, I've made some progress. It's definitely more easy than making the hull with the real wood strips, but it's also tricky, because if you don't, if you try to make the exact same curves as the wood strips below, you will end up with a lifted side of this thin layer, because it's very thin, so it's easy to lift up in an angle. Now, let me see if I can focus here. As you can see here, the wood strip gets very, very, very thin, ends up here. Also here, it begins very, very thin and ends up normally. So this is the way to do it in the entire hull. Probably I'm going to make another row here and fill it up, because this one tends to lift up here, as you can see. So I must change it. And wood strip by wood strip, I will end up closing the entire hull. The other side is not yet done at all. So, wolf. So, when I'm finished the second layer, I don't believe there's something that I need to film again. If there is, I will do. I will sand it down, and I'll get back to you to move on to make the rest of the hull, because definitely it's going to be some work in the hull after the second layer. Thank you very much for watching, guys. See you soon.